Take him out, take him out, bring him out dead, dead. Shot him up, boy. Hey, hey. One gun, two gun, three gun, four. Your mind is all about crime.
Shalom, this is Tazadak Gabal coming back here with this word in the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostle and the others, great millstone. Peace and salutation for the whole flock Akim that's pushing this word of true sincerity, and the speckled bird Akim that's teaching this truth through the four corners of the earth, pushing the doctrine of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right, the name of the Father is Yahweh, which you ignorantly call God. The name of His Son is Yahweh Shai, which you ignorantly call Jesus Christ. All right, so I just want to get with this lesson. You know, brothers did before, but a lot of brothers' pages are being taken down. And so I took this opportunity to put it out there, to be repetitive, and to show you what the Lord does not accept. The Lord, Yahweh Bashem Shai, does not accept this behavior, man. Okay? So this is more of a rebuke video for brothers and families that's taking arms before the Lord returns, because the Lord never said that, man. He said, he that killeth the sword shall die by the sword. Alright? Okay, and according to Zephaniah, he also states that wait upon me before I will rise up to the prey. Not you. Alright? Okay? We have to be patient and wait for these new bodies so we could be causing destruction too. Alright? So, you know, I'm not literally attacking this specific family here, because we've seen it throughout the years. We've seen the carnality of our people, man, that claim themselves to being the truth, knowing that's being carnal, man. All right? They're not being spiritual. Why? Because these people are natural. All right? So let's get the first scripture real quick. This is, let me get Corinthians. Get it out real quick. Let me get 1 Corinthians 2 and 15. All right, because our people is going with the emotions than going with logic. All right, they're not being in the spirit, man. Okay, all right. So this is okay, this is 1 Corinthians 2, verse 14. But the natural man receives not the things of the Spirit of the Most High. So clearly, this is not the Spirit of the Most High. Okay? This is the spirit of Satan. All right? This is the spirit of the world. All right? This is the spirit of throw your guns in the air. All right? That's not the spirit of the Lord. The spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahshua is like, you are clearly supposed to be the men of the light, right? So the men of light and the men of the children of the day are the ones that follow in the scriptures. You can't argue this one. Okay? 1 Corinthians 2 verse 14. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of the Most High, for they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. There you go. When you live yourself as carnal and be a natural, and everything, you're not able to discern things, man, in the spirit. Why? Because you're not following the scriptures. You're not reading. Okay? Did you forget Romans the 13th chapter? All right? This is the Lord's playbook. You cannot interfere because you're going against Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Waiting for this airplane to pass. You know, with their drugs imported in it. All right? You're going against the program of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai clearly say to wait upon me, for I will rise up on the prey. And you guys seem to skip over these scriptures and follow your wicked heart, man. And guess what's going to happen? It's going to lead you to your death. Why? Because you're following your leaders. All right? Let me get Isaiah, the 9th chapter. Isaiah 9. Let me see. Let me get that real quick. Isaiah 9. Verse 16. Okay? And it reads, hold up. Yeah, and it reads, for the leaders of this people caused them to err. So they clearly following somebody, one of their leaders, and their leaders of his example is leading them to death. This they getting this from their leaders, man. Let's read it. Isaiah 9, verse 16. So if you don't, hey, you guys over there, you don't like this video, just don't watch it, man. You be destroyed, all right? Don't say you haven't been warned, all right? Because you see a lot of silly comments in the comment board on brothers' pages, man. It shows that y'all just nothing but natural brute beast. You're not spiritual, all right? Isaiah 9, verse 16. For the leaders of this people cause them to err, and they that are led of them are destroyed. You're gonna be destroyed. But what you're portraying right here, man, you're putting a bullseye for Esau, Edom to come after you quickly. And guess what? The Lord's not going to be with you, man. Let's get that straight. Why? Because you're going against the orders of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. It's that simple. Let's get a scripture out real quick. Let me get Luke 11th chapter. All right, Luke 11th chapter, verse 21. And this seemed like to be the cutters of cutters, man. Okay? You cannot go over this one. All right? Luke 11, verse 21. When a strong man armor keepeth his palace, his goods are in peace. But when a stronger than he shall come upon him, who's that stronger than he shall come upon him? That's talking about Esau, Edom. Why? Because he had the blessing of the sword. All right? That's his blessing, not ours. Okay? Luke 11, verse 22. But when a stronger than he shall come upon him and overcome him, he take of him all his armor wherein he trusted and divided his spoils. He that is not with me is against me. And this is what you're clearly doing. You people out there with the same carnal minds with your guns. Okay? All right? You have no idea that the Lord is going to send someone stronger than you and take over your family and destroy your family. All right? And take all your goods, and guess what? He's going to divide the spoils amongst each other while you standing there helplessly tied down like a damn pig, man. While you watching your children being raped by these people, man. Why? Because you went against Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. That's what the scripture said. He is not with me is against me. So when you whip the Lord and you do everything what he says, okay, all right, what you clearly say in Zephaniah, wait upon me, and you're not clearly not doing that, man. So what you're doing, you're totally against him. You don't gather or not. You scatter of the sheep by doing it this way. There was many countless examples what happened over there in back in the ancient days, man. Clearly examples what happens when you go against the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Okay? Remember Masada? Do you remember Masada with Sicario and Masada? Remember that? What happened? Our people got destroyed up there. They spoiled. They ate each other. Cannibalism. Why? Because they clearly went against Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. They're clearly going against these prophecies. Okay? Alright? Let me get Judith. It's going to be a quick lesson. Not going to be too much. All right. This is Judith. 5th chapter, verse 19. All right? But now are they returned to their power, and are come up from the places where they scattered, and have possessed Jerusalem, where their sentries there are settled in the hill country, for it was desolate. All right, let's go to the next. All right. Now, therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error against this people, and they sin against their power, let us consider that this shall be their ruin. And this is how the other nations are clearly looking at you. Why? Because you're not trusting in Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. All right, this is an error. This is an error right here, man. Why? Because your leaders cause you to err. All right? And you sinning against the Most High. That's why the other nations saying, let us consider this shall be their ruin. And let's read it. Let's keep reading. All right? Give me a sec, brothers. Give me a sec. All right? This is Judah 5, verse 20. Now, therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error against this people, and they sin against their power, let us consider that this shall be their ruin. And let us go up, and we shall overcome them. So when you live in this carnal state of mind, you will be overcome by the enemy, period. You're supposed to wait upon him, okay? He gonna give us that new bodies to what? To break in pieces the nations, man. But we gotta wait upon the Lord first. First and foremost. So I suggest you brothers and sister families that having this mind state, this carnal mind state, I suggest you repent or what? Be destroyed. Okay? Let's get with the next verse. And you're going to see what happens when you do wait. Judah 5, verse 21. I'm just using it as an example. All right? And this is from a heathen, a choir, saying this, man. All right? Because he was speaking to the general Holofernes. All right? So let's get with the scripture. Judah 5, verse 21. But if there be no iniquity in their nation, meaning sin, let my Lord now pass by, lest their Lord defend them, and their power to be for them, and we become reproached before all the world. This is what happens when you wait upon the Lord. He said, wait upon me, for I will rise up on a prayer. And guess what? We're going to have those new bodies, and guess what? We're going to be thrashing instruments, man. Instruments of war. Okay? Not guns. Spiritual power, brothers. All right? Right now, you have to move like a serpent. You got to be wise, man. All right? You have to be wise in this forsaken kingdom, man. All right, we got to wait upon the Lord first, man. You can't live in a carnal mind, because what? That's enmity to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. All right? Let's get that up. Let me get the last scripture real quick. This is on Matthew 10, verse 16. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Right now, we're in the midst of wolves, man. You got false prophets out there. You got carnal-ass Negroes and Latinos out there. And Native Americans. We in a wicked world, brothers and sisters. All right? I'm talking to you men. Okay? All right? Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves, but ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. All right? That you may be blameless and harmless, the sons of the Most High, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked, perverse nation, among ye shine as lights in the world. You got to shine as lights in the world. Don't be part of this world. What you're portraying, you're thinking you're in a group called Onyx, man. But y'all don't got the bald heads, but y'all got fringes. Y'all look terrible, man. That's not the way of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. That's the way of Satan and this world. So you're supposed to portray yourself as lights of the world. All right? An example. All right? You got to move with wisdom. Be wise as a serpent, harmless as a dove, and be blameless, man. Because right now, you're blamed right now. And guess what? That's going to lead you to destruction. So I just want to do a quick lesson on that. Hope your brothers and sisters were edified. I want to give all praise and glory to Yahweh. Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rokakadash. Hey, double honors to the apostle, the other great millstone, and peace and salutation for the whole Philek Akim. That's pushing the word, truth and serving. To then, another video. Shalom.